Hello there, I'm George the Kangaroo, and today I have something in my little pouch. This is the Aiva Prodigy Air 2, and it is going to be the star of today's review. This is a true wireless Bluetooth EM, and it has a price of about $70, so it is in that range of just sweet price performance ratio spot. I love doing a bit of a crazy stuff, so today I'm reviewing the Prodigy Air 2 from Aiva. I couldn't even find the price for those, I couldn't find much of a technical information, it looks like they don't really have a website page yet, so at the moment I'm filming this video, I can't really say much about them in terms of technicals. Maybe at the moment I'm editing it, I will add a few if they are available by then. The Prodigy 2 from Aiva are interesting because the first one was a pretty good price performance ratio, but I already noticed a huge issue with the Prodigy Air 2 from Aiva. I actually reviewed a few things from Aiva, like a large speaker, the Exos 8, and I loved that speaker. It was pretty cool. It was like a huge boombox. I couldn't even carry it on my shoulders, I'll be honest with you. It was about 8 kilograms of a speaker, if I remember it correctly, and it was huge. It was heavy, it was inconvenient, it was just... That being said, it sounded very good, and it was actually pretty cool in terms of overall sound if you didn't want to take it out. It was more of a room speaker that you would have somewhere in your room and you would enjoy music out of it, but Aiva really knows how to do bass. That speaker was all about the bass, the boom. And now we have the Prodigy 2, a true wireless EM made by Aiva. The only page I could find was actually a patent filled by Aiva, where they actually wrote every single detail they could about their EM, like who makes them, certificates, but not actually a product page. Anyways, they have up to 6 hours of actual playtime on a single charge. That is actually not bad. It is actually kind of funny that they used an almost empty and almost depleted icon to show the 6 hours. But yeah, 6 hours is pretty good for a true wireless EM. It is no joking matter. They have 24 total playtime, which means that you can feel them about 4 times from the charging case. You can actually activate Google or Siri by pressing a button on them, and they have a button. Oh, I'm so happy that they have a button. I don't have to deal with those touch true wireless EMs anymore. And they have Bluetooth, and that is pretty much it. The Bluetooth is not aptX, LDAC, it's just SBC. And that was a huge disappointment at first. Like, wow, did they just make them SBC? I was having such a good time before reading that on my smartphone. But as time passed, I actually learned to enjoy the Air 2, as you'll probably enjoy them if you get them. The unboxing experience is actually pretty cool, very easy to unbox and rebox, and that is a good thing for me as a reviewer because I tend to unbox things a lot and rebox them. There is a charging / carrying case inside which has a Type-C connector. I love having a Type-C connector, it's just nice, no micro SD connectors. There is a little cardboard box in which you can find the charging cable. It doesn't really need a data cable since the case is not meant to be connected to a computer. And there are 5 other pairs of tips because one is already installed. So 6 pairs of tips in total. That is pretty good. I think that the number of tips is actually pretty cool. The charging / carrying case is a blast. I really am having fun with it because it has dots on the front or LEDs which show you how charged it is. And when you open it, you can see how charged it is. Usually it does that LED thing where it shows you. The EMs inside are even better. Those are the EMs, and let me tell you something, the Air 2 sounds good. I don't know if the original sounded good, but the Air 2 is pretty nice. The sound tends to be very dynamic, punchy, has a beautiful bass, it is loud enough to be enjoyable. The EMs are very comfortable despite feeling very cheap. They actually feel very cheaply built because they are very light, but that leads to an extreme amount of comfort, and I cannot emphasize this enough, but sometimes have to make a sacrifice. You are making a choice. Do you make a very comfortable and ergonomic EM, or do you make it fancy and heavy and uncomfortable? They look cheap. The plastic looks pretty cheap because it is so light. It is not one of those EMs where you can say, wow, it has so much inside. No, they have only the chips inside and the drive. Once you install them, you need to imagine the fact that they sit kind of like this in your ear. So this is the right earpiece, and it sits kind of, there is a woman voice screaming in my ear when I insert them and when I open them, And this is how the left earpiece looks like. As you can see, there is a lot of space left in my ear, so I could fit two of those in each of my ears, which means that they will fit even small ears perfectly. That is cool. On the other hand, I would say that having 1 hour and a half of charging time is not great. They charge pretty slowly. I have seen many EMs that offer much lower charging times, and that is a thing. This being said, at this price point, the sonic quality is just outstanding. A lot of people have blamed the original for being quite narrow in soundstage and for being intimate. Well, let me tell you something. The Air 2 is not intimate at all. I don't know if you are expecting them to be intimate or if they are expected to, but they actually sound kind of like the Lipertec Tevi, which was just perfect, and they cost $30 less, at least if they are introduced at the same price like the original Prodigy Air was. The case is also made of plastic, and you can kind of tell it. It is not the most good looking case out there. It has only 600 milliwatts of power, but the case tends to be pretty okay overall. It does not get scratched easily, and that is a big thing, because there are EMs out there which look amazing, sound amazing, but they get destroyed in no time. The Aiva Prodigy Air 2 does not get destroyed easily, and you may come to me and ask me, why would I purchase this? What makes this special, and why wouldn't I go with Lipertec Tevi or any of the other well-proven true wireless EMs like the Master and Dynamic MW07 Plus? Well, my answer to you, my friends, is that this one is perfect if you like a warm V-shaped sound. They have a special mid-range that is warm, magical, musical. It just sounds good. It is so nice. The bass is quite enhanced, that it has a ton of sub-lows, a ton of blow, a ton of punch, a ton of just power. The bass is just nice. The treble is not smooth. It is one of those sparklier treble with a lot of presence, a lot of life in it. They have a wide soundstage. I don't know how the original was narrow and this one is wide, but this one is pretty wide overall. It doesn't really have a lot of depth, but it has a good amount of width. They have a good amount of air and sparkle in the sound, and they have a pretty good instrument separation too, so things don't really sound like they are match up together. This means that you can enjoy them even with more complex music like jazz or like metal or even classical. They are pretty general EMs, and that is a cool thing, because I was able to enjoy them with pretty much anything from Katy Perry to Melanie Martinez to Metallica, all the way to some George Enescu, a Romanian composer making classical. At the end of the day, I'm able to easily enjoy them with anything, and that is a cool thing. With electronic and EDM, I'm able to jump around, party. With classical, I'm able to sit back, just listen for that classical music, for all the instruments. They have this thing where they actually resolve quite well for the price point. They have a pretty good overall resolving ability. Being just $70, I was expecting them to be quite bland. I was expecting a pretty compressed sound, and when I saw the fact that they only have SBC, I kinda wanted to not like them. I was like, I am not going to like them. I'm going to dislike this experience. But upon hearing them, I was blown away. I couldn't even tell you. Why do they sound so good? They have only SBC. They don't have APTX. They don't have LDAC. They are just SBC. So the codec inside of them is pretty limited. And that is the fun part. Even if they had LDAC or APTX, they probably would have sounded the same, because the company optimized the usage of the driver to be at the maximum, which means that the driver is as resolving as it could ever be. They pretty much don't have a driver that would resolve more detail, even if more detail was fed to it. They just managed to software optimize every single drop of performance there was inside of it. They have Bluetooth 5, which means that they have a pretty good range, pretty good Bluetooth reliability, and having SBC means that you can do a lot of sport with them without them falling out of your ears. The main selling points of it are that it is very comfortable. It is tiny, so it will work with small ears. Not a lot of true wireless EMs do that. Most of them fell pretty with small ears because they tend to be larger than my ears, and my ears are medium size. So yeah, those one will also work with small ears. They are very lightweight. You don't really sweat while wearing them, and you could even use spin fit tips if you wanted to. At the end of the day, they are a really nice general sounding EMs. They don't sound narrow. They sound pretty wide. They sound pretty dynamic, and they have a commercial type of sound that works with pretty much everything. I cannot tell you how much I recommend them. They are just nice. For $70, it is a nice true wireless EM, the Aiva Prodigy Air. I hope this video has been as nice as those EMs are. I hope you enjoyed your time on Audiophile Heaven. I hope you'll like this video if you enjoyed it. I also hope you'll subscribe to Audiophile Heaven. I hope you have a lovely week in there, and we'll see each other really soon. Bye bye.